Our working group carries out paleontology research in the Canary Islands. Paleontologists study the remains of organisms preserved as fossils in rock formations. We interpret and reconstruct the changes in land and marine fauna and investigate the possible consequences of these changes for the preservation of life. The Canary Islands are not well known for their fossils. It's difficult to imagine that the volcanic terrain of oceanic islands might produce such great paleontological treasures. The remains of organisms or traces of their existence, dating back 140 million years, up until modern times. The remains of reefs and ancient beach lines bear witness to past times and to paleo-environmental changes in the islands through the marine ecosystem. The rising of the Canary Islands led to the creation of new territories, which were widely colonized by plants, large birds, and turtles that now are extinct and fossilized in paleodune and volcanic material. Some of these fossil remains are more than 6 million years old. The fossils, preserved in hundreds of interspersed paleosoils in the paleodunes, are extremely useful for our research group because they facilitate the study of changes in fauna and the reconstruction of the paleoclimate. The paleosoils were formed during the Quaternary period, the most recent period in the history of Earth, which covers the last 2.5 million years. Also, almost complete vertebrate fossil skeletons have been found in volcanic caves, buried in the sedimentary filling or in cave soil. There are remains of giant lizards or different types of birds and mammals like rats or mice, many of them extinct nowadays. The study of fossil records in the Canary Islands allows us to understand the origin of the current biodiversity and to reconstruct the environmental conditions in which species appeared, in which their populations expanded, or in which their extinction ultimately came about. It also allows us to establish paleontological zones of great cultural and tourist interest. One of our recent studies focused on analyzing fossil traces of the paleosoils of the Quaternary period. Amongst our findings is the description of new fossil traces, the scientific name of which is Palaemyrrhichus castellanosis. These traces provide the first reliable evidence of bees in the fossil record of the Canary Islands. In their reproductive cycle, these solitary bees build nests in the ground at various depths. The nests consist of a main gallery that leads to one or more small cells, in which the bees store food and lay eggs. In order to maintain optimal environmental conditions for the larva to develop and reach maturity, and to prevent the entry of predators, bees build spiral closure caps in which they place food and eggs. These structures, hitherto unknown in the Canary Islands, prove that many of the numerous fossil insect traces found in the paleodunes of the Quaternary period are in fact traces of those bees. Along with the fossil traces, the terrestrial gastropods are the most abundant fossils. In this period, we have identified the arrival of new species such as Coglicella. It's easy to identify this elongated snail which lived for a limited time in Fuerteventura in the deposits. Various environmental changes were the main causes of their extinction, but their presence allows us to correlate the deposits with different locations on the island based on age, something which is of great biochronological interest. Another aspect of our line of work, conservation paleontology, focuses on the study of fossils in volcanic caves. Of particular note is our publication of the ancient geographical distribution of the giant lizard of El Hierro and of the areas where these fossils' remains were laid during the Quaternary period. These results have been very useful for the local administration in their efforts to reintroduce the species in its natural environment. Our group has been developing a second line of research on ways of enhancing the economic and cultural exploitation of our paleontological patrimony. By analyzing the fossil record of the Canary Islands as a whole, we've identified a series of paleontological points of interest. These points, distributed around the islands of the archipelago, are the basis for establishing the evolutionary history of the Canary Islands, a history that includes the submarine phase, when the volcanic structure begins to form, until their immersion, and the subsequent changes that result in the geography which we know today. One of the best examples is the location of the deposit at Mancha La Laja in Bajamar, located in the World Heritage Site, the city of La Laguna in Tenerife. We have proposed a route which includes this deposit. The paleontological study of this deposit has enabled us to determine that more than 700 million years ago, in the area of the north of Tenerife, located between Jover and Bajamar, there was a landscape very different to the one that we find there today. This landscape was made up of mobile yellow sand dunes and small coastal lagoons similar to those we now find in the coast of Coralejo or Costa Calma in Fuerteventura. The volcanic eruptions related with the dorsal that created the island of Tenerife as we know it, covered and changed the coastal Paleoduna ecosystems of the north of the island. Our results have been obtained using the standard methodology in paleontology. First, we look for paleontological deposits by reviewing the existing geological cartography. Next, we describe the layers that form the deposit, collect fossil samples in each of the described levels, and then clean up and prepare the fossil material in the laboratory for a range of purposes, including systematic study to assign the sample to a known or a new species, geochemical study to reconstruct the characteristics of the paleoenvironment, for example, the paleon temperature. We have carried out these studies in collaboration with the National Council for Scientific Research, the University of Granada and the University of Salamanca. We determine the ages of the fossils by means of the amino acid racemization method, a process that's carried out at the Madrid Polytechnic University. The results from our work on biodiversity conservation paleontology allows us to discover extinct species, to differentiate between invasive and non-invasive species, and to determine the distribution and abundance of ancient endangered species, and to look for the best strategy for their reintroduction. We believe that the conservation of biodiversity and ecosystems is crucial to the well-being of society. In the future, our group intends to continue studying fossils in the geological context of volcanic and oceanic islands. These data will allow society on the one hand to develop a new sustainable economic niche, and on the other, to anticipate changes that will affect the ecosystems as a result of the different environmental contexts that develop with the passing of time.